Senator, Mrs. Lyons, are you ready?
I'm ready. Good morning, and welcome to our final assembly. I would like to begin with the Pledge of Allegiance today, and Sam Sabah will lead us in the pledge. Declare the 2020-2021 school year over. One of our lower school students gave me a poem recently, which I think expresses the way many of us are feeling today. So I would like to begin our assembly by reading it to you. It is called The Last Day of School. I'm so glad it's finally over. I've waited all year for this day. It's ended, concluded, and finished. The one word for this is hooray. So why am I getting this feeling that maybe I'll miss everyone? And why is there always some sadness when everything's over and done? So it is with mixed feelings that we end the school year today. I spent some time this week thinking about a message that I would like to leave with you as I send you all for your summer vacation. I thought especially about our fourth graders, who today will receive their Buckley B's and move on to upper school. Our fourth graders are a remarkable class. They have certainly shown that during this past year. They are resilient, intelligent, hardworking, talented, and most of all, kind and compassionate. This has been an incredible year for our fourth graders. They willingly followed all the COVID protocols when they returned to school in September, and they have worked so hard and accomplished so much during their fourth grade year. Surely the pandemic of 2020 will be a part of our history. I can imagine our fourth graders one day telling their children and even their grandchildren about this experience. I am immensely proud of each one of our fourth graders. It seemed at times as though they had wings and they soared over the challenges that crossed their paths. At our lower school assembly last Friday, we recognized several students for their accomplishments in writing, math, and music. And so as I was thinking about our fourth graders, I thought about the awards that I would like to give this class today. I would begin by giving them an award for empathy, for I have seen their kindness and compassion towards one another. They have an extraordinary ability to feel someone else's feelings. I would also give them an award for resilience, for I have seen how they were able to bounce back and recover when they thought they had failed at something. I would also give them an award for flexibility, for I have seen how they have learned that in academics, as in life, when one thing doesn't work, you try something else. And I would give them an award for optimism, for I have seen that they take risks that are worth taking. They have learned that when you try something new, you give it your best shot, because that is how you learn and grow. And finally, I would give them an award for persistence, because I have seen that they have learned to stick with something even when it is challenging. A very important aspect of our fourth grade literacy program is looking for life lessons in books that they read or in stories that their teachers read aloud to them. Books like Wonder, Front Desk by Kelly Rang, An Invisible Thread by Laura Schroff. All of these books have important life lessons which our fourth graders can apply to their own lives. So when I met with the fourth graders last week, I asked them to tell me about some of the most important life lessons that they have learned during their lower school years. I'm going to share some of them with you. Kind words do not cost much, but they accomplish so much. One act of kindness can change a person's life forever. When you feel lost, believe in miracles and they will happen. If you make a mistake, you can start over. If you never try, you will never succeed, so give everything your best effort. Never give up on yourself, no matter how hard something is. Do not always have to be right. Sometimes you can choose to be kind instead. and always try to be the best person you can be, even if some days you don't feel like you are the best person. And so, fourth graders, I confidently send you on to upper school today. I am inspired by all of the wonderful life lessons that you will take with you. I know that you will remember how a simple act of kindness can change a person's life. I know that if you make a mistake, you will start over. I know that you will always try to be the best person you can be. I know that you will never give up on anything and give everything your best effort. I know that when you feel lost, you will believe in miracles and they will happen. You are well prepared for the challenges that lie ahead. You will strive for greatness and you will hold on to your dreams. Your lower school memories will always be part of you. Your dreams are before you and everything you need to succeed is within you. Have a wonderful summer. And now we will enjoy a musical tribute to the fourth grade by our kindergarten, first, and second grade students.
Yeah.
I'd like to thank Dr. Glennon, Mrs. Chun, and Mr. Topel for helping to put together this beautiful video of our lower school students. Thank you so much for all of your hard work. Now, fourth graders, this is the moment you have been waiting for. Dr. Jewell will be calling your name, and when you come up, you will receive your Buckley B, and you will be presented to Mr. Kriebel as you enter upper school. Give me a thumbs up if you're ready. Okay, Dr. Jewell.
Thank you, Mrs. Lyons, and thank you for the beautiful music this morning. This was really terrific. Can I get another show of thumbs up if you're ready, fourth graders, to become upper schoolers? All right, I think they're all ready, Mrs. Lyons. Are you ready? All right, let us start then. Morgan Nicole Anderson. Enzo R. Fischetti. Sophia Lynn Gonzalez. Watching from home this morning. Victoria Mattia Aubrey James. Winter Elizabeth Lane. Kayla Sonura Lessie. E.G. Jeremy Luke. Haley Samia Mohammed. Kaden Shadi Nassar. Nelson Rowling Zephyrin Osain Wimsey. Valentina Sofia Motto. Naya Elise Otero. Reagan Alexis Phillips. Anna Rani Savlevich. Julian Brooke Rosenthal. Sam Joseph Sabah. Paige Francis Sean. Sophie Situ. Adriana Scanderi. Ashton Logan Spence. Cadence Lee Chloe Suarez. Alyssa Ake Sugiyama. Carter Harrison Tang. Name Milana Walsh Cohen. Rena Wu. And Erica Yedgaroff.
So, Mr. Kriebel, I proudly present to you the class of 2025.
Thank you.
That was an amazing song. You can go back to your seats now. But what an amazing song, and I love the fact that it was an original. Thank you, Dr. Glenn, and whoever else is responsible for composing the words. Themselves?
Yeah.
All right, fifth graders. Big round of applause, because this was really... And on top of things, I can't believe you memorized all those words. That was really, really terrific. So I'm just about to close this school year, but before we do that, it's very important that you recognize all the people who have helped you be where you are now. And this morning, I want to hear, just not just from you, but also the third, second, first graders and kindergartners who are watching, a big, big round of applause for Mrs. Lyons and all the lower school teachers. Let's hear it for them. So also before I close, I wanted to announce the results of Field Day and the Red Blue competition. Would you be interested in knowing who won? Yes? Okay, so this was done last night. So I'm gonna start with Field Day, right? Two separate things. You can win Field Day and lose for the year, or, you know, vice versa, or win both. So the blue team on Field Day scored 594 points. Let's hear it for the blue team. The red team scored 472 points, and therefore the blue team was the winner of Field Day this year. Let's get going. When you add up all the points for the entire year, right, the red team scored 1,207 points, and the blue team 1,334 points. So the blue team is the winner of the 2020-21 competition. Congratulations. It was very close. If you look at the scores, very, very close. So I hope you all have a great summer. I know you're upper schoolers yet, but believe it or not, you're not quite teenagers yet. You're still kids. Yeah. So the most important thing you have to do for this summer is to continue to be kids and not try to be teenagers yet. You have plenty of time for that. Be kids this summer. Let go of all the electronics that you may have. Turn them off. Throw them out. I mean, don't throw out your phones, but put them away somewhere where you're not going to look at them for another 3 months. I promise you, you'll feel a lot better. Don't do TikTok this summer. There are so many other things that you could be doing. So you should spend, instead of being on your electronics, you should spend time outside. We're going to have a beautiful summer. Be outside, play, read good books, write good stories. Right, Ms. Reedy? Isn't that what they should be doing? Exactly. And most days, do nothing at all. You will actually really enjoy that as well. So have a great, great summer. And it is now time now, Mrs. Lyons, you ready? The teacher, I know we're all ready. It is now time for me to declare the 2020, and you can make some noise after that, right? Fourth grade in the classrooms. The 2020-21 school year over, and summer to begin. Woo! I see Mrs. Knox and Mrs. Powers quite excited as well, as they should. They've worked really, really hard all year round, as well as all the other teachers in the lower school, and they deserve a break, that's for sure. Have a great summer, everybody. Thank you.
Okay, so I think we're ready. Thank you for your attention, boys and girls. You did everything perfectly. I am so proud of you. Okay, so when the